Hey guys, this is your friend Mainak from Civil Center and I welcome all of you back to our channel. So friends, in today's video we'll show you how to remove the warnings of footings in Tekla Structural Designer and whether these warnings are serious or not. So friends, as you can see, we have designed the footings here. This has been designed as per the European code and these are all safe. So let's once again design all the footings for you. So all the loadings have been given in the building and the load combinations have been generated, and after that we had provided the footings. We'll just do it again for you. Just delete the footings. So I'll unselect everything, only keep the pad base. I'll delete it. So we can go to our foundation option. We can just select the pad base column. We can select this pad bases and then design pad bases. So as you can see, this all these things have passed. If you want, you can also go to the structure window and you can also go to the structure base one and you can just hover over to the drawing option and generate your various drawings from here. Go to drawing management, foundation layout, and you can check the content. Also, we can select the base level and then click on OK and then view drawing. OK, so you can view the foundation drawings here. All the depths, sizes along with the reinforcement details have been given. This has been designed in the European code. As you can see from here, we can go to the home option, go to the model settings. This has been designed as per Euro code and it is not showing any warnings. So now if you want to design it as per the IS code, it shows some warnings. Let's just check that. We'll go to the model settings, we'll just change this to Indian codes and then OK. And after that, obviously we have not applied seismic and wind loads, so we'll just generate the load combinations again because the code has been changed. We'll go to the combinations, we'll generate the load combinations again as per the Indian codes. Next, finish, and then OK. So now we have the Indian code selected. We'll just select the footings once again and then delete it. We only want to delete the footings or the pad base. We'll delete them and now we'll apply the pad bases again. And this time we'll design it as per the Indian codes. So pad base columns, all pad bases applied, design pad bases. So as you can see, this is showing unknown because we haven't designed the building yet. We'll just click on Control Z and then we'll go to design and then we'll click on design all static. So after clicking on design all static, we can go to the foundation options and then pad base columns, and assign the pad bases, design the pad bases. So as you can see, the pad bases have been safe, but it's showing some warning. We can just click on design member and check. So everything, bearing capacity, concrete cover, punching shear, every checks they have passed, but only they have the footing has failed in the development length. As you can see here, the code also, if you want, you can just it will be visible from here. You can expand it and you can check it from here. It is showing warning for development length in development length of compression bar. It's also written to keep the footing depth smaller. Development length for compression bar can be reduced by suitably choosing the dowel bars or the starter bars of smaller diameter and the number of dowels increased to satisfy the required area. So this thing is showing warnings, but you can ignore these warnings while you know the execution of the particular construction. You need to make sure that you provide dowel bars or the starter bars in your footing so that it connects the columns to the footing, so which we generally usually provide. So you can just ignore this particular warnings in Tekla Structural Designer. So that's all. We can conclude that if there is a warning for your development length, it can be ignored given the fact that you provide the dowel bars in execution or in your detailing drawings. So friends, hope this concept was useful. Today we had shown how to assign the foundations, how to change from European code to Indian code, and then design the building again. So we keep coming up with more videos where you play around with various options of the software so that it can be useful for you. So if you found this video useful, leave a like, and if you want videos on any other topic, you can just hit the comment box. See you again in the next video. Bye bye.